You've heard of LLMs, AI, artificial intelligence. You've probably even heard the great term vibe coding, where you get AI tools to write code for you. Now, people can cope all day that these tools are never gonna get better, they're never gonna be good, and you can argue from like a moral perspective whether or not they should be used, but they're getting to a point where people are legitimately losing jobs. So, that's great. Now, the problem is right now, they're not perfect, and they're not amazing, and have a very bad habit of hallucinating things, which is a technical term for making shit up. A very common example we've all seen is referencing packages that don't exist. But what if suddenly that wasn't true anymore? What if the problem of non-existent packages just vanished into thin air, like the problem never existed? Not because there was a sudden leap in the quality of these tools. No, that would be a good thing. But instead, because malicious actors realized there is a perfect attack vector here. Meet the rise of slop squatting. How AI hallucinations are fueling a new class of supply chain attacks. Slop squatting is a new supply chain threat where AI-assisted code generators recommend hallucinated packages that attackers register and weaponize. So basically, if there is a commonly reported fake package, attackers make that package and then stick malware in it. So your tools don't complain. There's a package there. Not the package you thought it was, though. This is a play on terms like domain squatting, where people come along and buy up potentially valuable domains that nobody's using yet, but it's a common word, it's a short domain, and there's potentially someone who wants it, and then wait until someone comes along they can charge a lot of money for. But maybe more accurately, a play on terms like typo squatting, where you buy a similar sounding domain to a legitimate site, say a goggle.com instead of google.com. You make the site look like Google, you have a login page, everything there, and basically try to get login credentials and other information from unsuspecting users. In the case of slop squatting, when the AI generates a fake package, you go and register that package, have malware in it, do whatever you want to it, and basically, they just gave you access to their system. Now, I can sit here and say I feel bad for people, this is so terrible, but look, there's a part of me that thinks this is genuinely genius, and I kinda wish I came up with the idea myself. Large language models, LLMs, are becoming a staple in modern development workflows. AI-powered code assistant tools like Copilot, ChatGPT, and Cursor are now used to help write everything from web apps to automation script. They deliver industry-altering productivity gains, but also introduce new risks, some of them entirely novel. One such risk: slop squatting. I know a lot of people in the FOSS world really hate these tools, and again, from that moral perspective of, you know, actually caring about software licenses, yeah, I understand, and I have my, concerns with these as well. At the same time, though, if you spend any amount of time in a developer forum, you're going to see a lot of discourse around this tooling, and a lot of people just use it and don't really think twice about it. So, yes, it is fair to say that we'll see how much this becomes true, but it's certainly aiming to be that, and there's a lot of people very hopeful to make that happen. The term slop squatting was coined by Python Software Foundation developer in residence Seth Larson and popularized in a recent post by ecosite.ms creator Andrew Nesbitt. It refers to the practice of registering a non-existent package name hallucinated by an LLM in hopes that someone, guided by an AI assistant, will copy and paste it and install it without realizing it's fake. Now, whilst it is claimed to be coined by Seth Larson, I can't find any evidence of that actually being the case. I don't know where he actually said it, whether it was in a public talk, whether it's private DMs, you know, just a personal discussion in person. Andrew credits Seth for making the term, and Andrew appears to be the second person to reference it, so that's basically all the evidence we have. Anyway, in the grand scheme of things, it doesn't actually matter who made the term. What matters a lot more is this is a term that is gaining a lot of steam, and it already has a Wikipedia page, even though the term has only existed for arguably like 3 weeks. Now you might be thinking, okay, if this is abusing AI hallucinations or making things up, whatever term you want to be using, how is there an attack vector here? Because if this is just random noise, if it's just generating random package names, you're not going to have two prompts that result in the same output giving you a point to attack on. You'd just be targeting individual users. The thing is, though, it's not entirely random noise. There appears to be, at least right now, some consistency in the nonsense it makes up. And recently, there was an academic paper on the hallucination of these models. We have a package for you, a comprehensive analysis of package hallucinations by code-generating LLMs, offering the first rigorous, large-scale analysis of package hallucinations in LLM-generated code. The research was conducted by a team from the University of Texas at San Antonio, Virginia Tech, and the University of Oklahoma, and was recently made available to the public in a preprint. The researchers tested 16 leading code generation models, both commercial and open source. The term open source in AI is a bit weird, but sure, we'll go with that, generating a total of 576,000 Python and JavaScript code samples. Now, the results you get in different language ecosystems may be different. However, these are major places these tools are being used. If you'd like to read the paper, I'll leave this link down below, but the main points here are included in the article. So 19.7% of all recommended packages didn't exist. This is effectively 1 in 5. Open source models hallucinated far more frequently, 21.7% on average, compared to commercial models at 5.2%. This makes a lot of sense because, you know, the commercial models, there's a lot of money dumped into them, they're often bigger models. Understandably, yeah, that is probably what's going to happen. The worst offenders, CodeLlama 7b and CodeLlama 34b, hallucinated in over a third of outputs. GPT-4 Turbo had the best performance with a hallucination rate of just 3.59% across all models. The researchers observed over 205,000 unique hallucinated package names. And yes, that is a lot of unique packages. However, that is not the end of it. In a follow-up experiment, the researchers reran 500 prompts that had previously triggered hallucinations, 10 times each. They found an interesting split when analyzing how often hallucinated packages reappeared in repeated generations. When rerunning the same hallucination-triggering prompt 10 times, 43% of hallucinated packages were repeated every time, while 39% never reappeared. This stark contrast suggests a bimodal pattern in model behavior. Hallucinations are either highly stable or entirely unpredictable. Overall, 58% of hallucinated packages were repeated more than once across 10 runs, indicating that a majority of hallucinations are not just random noise, but repeatable artifacts of how the models respond to certain prompts. That repeatability increases their value to attackers, making it easier to identify viable slop-swatting targets by observing just a small number of model outputs. If they are repeatable, they are exploitable. Now, if the fake package names were just random strings of nonsense but still repeatable, yes, that would be a problem, but it's more of a problem because they look plausible and semantically convincing. Only 13% of hallucinations were simple off-by-one typos, which effectively looks like typo squatting, which is a whole separate issue we talked about earlier. 38% had moderate string similarity to real packages, suggesting overlap in naming structure or common usage patterns, though the exact names were not disclosed. Nearly half had high dissimilarity scores, indicating they were fully fabricated, yet still believable in context. So it didn't look like an existing package, but contextually, it made sense. They weren't random strings of characters. If you're looking for an animation library, it would be some name that you would give an animation library. Now, an obvious question is, do some of these packages exist or existed in the past, just in a different ecosystem? They found that 8.7% of hallucinated Python packages were actually valid NPM packages, suggesting that LLMs sometimes confuse language when suggesting dependencies. This makes a lot of sense, as they are both, you know, very high level, very easy to use languages, and there's going to be a lot of information about both of these languages and development ecosystems in these models, but the models don't understand the full context of what you're doing. They're basically just glorified token generators. It's a bit more complex than that, but that's effectively what they are. On the other hand, when it comes to real but deleted packages, only 0.17% of hallucinated names match packages removed from PyPy between 2020 and 2022. So there were certainly some, but not that many. The reason why NPM isn't included here is due to things that happened in the past with NPM, it's basically impossible to remove a package from NPM anymore. One of the more encouraging findings was that some models, particularly GPT-4 Turbo and DeepSeek, were able to correctly identify hallucinated package names they had just generated, achieving over 75% accuracy in internal detection tests. This points towards possible mitigation strategies like self-refinement, where a model reviews its own output for plausibility before presenting it to the user. This does obviously lead to some problems where, in cases that it isn't able to detect that, it is extra certain that what it is saying is real. Package confusion attacks like typo squatting, dependency confusion, and now slop squatting continue to be one of the most effective ways to compromise open source ecosystems. LLMs add a new layer of exposure. Hallucinated packages can be generated consistently and shared widely through auto completions, tutorials, and AI assisted code snippets. This is the other problem. People are making tutorials entirely AI generated. So you can have malware packages that you know are on a popular site. And yeah, right, that's great. This threat scales. If a single hallucinated package becomes widely recommended by AI tools and an attacker has registered that name, the potential for widespread compromise is real. And given that many developers trust the output of AI tools without rigorous validation, the window of opportunity is wide open. This is especially true when we look at things like vibe coding. Any actual developer should be, you know, validating the thing they are seeing. But more and more, I'm seeing people just blindly take what is being done, and then, you know, just seeing what happens. Now, you may not be a vibe coder, but this is still a problem that can affect you. So, we have this issue where search engines, when you search for something, the first result you get now is an AI-generated summary. And a lot of people will see that and think, okay, well, that's, you know, answering the thing that I want. And if it mentions, say, a package name, you might go and install that package name. So if you know there is some popular query that is recommending a fake package, well, look at that. It's an attack vector sitting right there. So even if you don't go and use these AI tools directly, you can still be affected. Then again, you have the issue of online tutorials, documentation, things like that, which may have used AI-generated output and may recommend packages which are now being squatted by a malware developer. Now, this entire time you might be thinking, ah, that's not something that could happen in the real world. That's never gonna happen. Oh, well, before the term slop squatting even existed, AI hallucinates software packages and devs download them, even if potentially poisoned with malware. This was done by a security researcher, thankfully for Alibaba, not a malware developer. So, at the time of writing this article, there was a command in the graph translator installation instructions for installing a Python package, Hugging Face, Hugging Face-CLI. Now, there is a real Hugging Face-CLI, but that is not how you install it. It is Hugging Face underscore hub square bracket CLI. So what happened here is in December, he constantly kept seeing generative AI reference Hugging Face-CLI. So he went and made that fake package. Then a couple of months later, Alibaba started referencing it in their own installation instructions instead of the real Hugging Face tool. So I'm assuming what happened here is someone really trusts AI-generated output. They asked one of these tools, hey, how do I install this? They noticed the README said the right thing and then changed it to say the wrong thing that the AI said was the right thing. And that's basically how this happened. It's dumb and it shouldn't have happened, but it literally already happened. Now, the rest of the article is just an ad for Socket's tool. So if you want to read it, I don't know, be my guest. I'll leave this link down below. But this is a problem that companies are gonna have to deal with as they are hiring developers who are far more willing to use these AI tools, who have been using these AI tools since the day they started programming. This is going to be something that there needs to be systems in place to check packages, to verify packages, and ensure that anytime something new is added, you know what is being added. So, welcome to the new world we live in, where you gotta make sure that if you're installing a package, well, it's not just a matter of typo squatting now. It's not just a matter of, oh, there might be fake packages. Well, if you happen to look up a guide, you happen to look up some documentation, worse yet, you actually use these AI tools to write the code for you, you might just download malware. Yeah. Enjoy! So, if you liked the video, go like the video. If you really liked the video, and actually let me know your thoughts down below if you happen to have run into any packages. Do you use these AI tools? I'd like to know. I know that some projects in the FOSS world have been just outright banning them. And yeah, maybe that's a good thing. I don't know. Maybe, well, let me know what your company does if you happen to be a professional developer. I'd love to know. So, if you really like the video and you want to become one of these amazing people over here, check out the Patreon, subscribe, Silly Berope, linked in the description down below. That's going to be it for me, and this is so stupid. What is this?